Suarez. I was saying, the way it is in my heart, you know. And the heart of so many Nigerians, you know. The truth is, I can't be leading 4-0 to Sierra Leone and concede 4 goals for no reason. There's no reason. Since I became the president of NFL, this is the worst loss I've seen in my life. The next few days, I wonder I'm going to sleep. It's not because of losing. It's not because we won't qualify for the Nations Cup. It's certainly because these two at the end of the year, these are our last match at all. You know the way, the passion, the love Nigerians have for this game. It's football. Definitely it's football. It can go either way. But what happened to us? Were we complacent? Were we just so comfortable that we're leading 4-0 and all of a sudden the goals start coming in? At the end of the day, nobody's going to call your name. Everybody's a coach, and I'm a penny. That is the truth. But unfortunately, he's not going to be the one. He's not the one on the pitch. I'm not the one on the pitch. I saw the reaction of your captain after they scored the fourth goal, and I shed tears for the first time in a long time. That spirit of competition is not there anymore to me, and that's the truth. I'm not the coach. If I were the coach, there are some people I would select, there are some people that will not come to the team again. And that's the truth. Nigeria has 200 million people. We are 11. We should consider ourselves privileged playing for the national team. And that's the truth. We should consider ourselves privileged playing for the national team. It hurts me so deep. It hurts all of us. I cannot even think of anything else. Because we put in a lot. I did a checklist yesterday. The flights, the immigration, custom, everything. Just to make sure that everything goes seamlessly. Should I call this a wake-up call?
No, I won't.
We've woken up. This is Nigeria. It's a big country. We don't wake up playing Sierra Leone. You wake up playing Brazil. You wake up playing Argentina. You wake up playing Senegal. So please. If it was only a scoreless draw, it would have been a different ballgame. From the defense to the midfield of attack. That will make us be that green, white, green that we are proud. Footballing nation. It's for us to go to Sierra Leone and beat them that 4-0 on reply. It's not winning. Winning is an understatement. It's to give them that 4-0 and make sure they don't score one. That is the only thing we'll do from the blast of the whistle to the end of that game. I'm also bothered about our ranking. I'm bothered about so many things that possibly people are not bothered about. We take the blame every day. When I sat down to look at the checklist, what has not been done? Ask him, I'll call the secretary, call the team doctor, call everything. I'm the president, but I took charge because of the importance of this game to you and to Nigerians. So please, I'm very emotional now. I feel very pain. I feel extremely pained. I'm not going to lie to you. When I was coming, oh, cheer them up. No, I'm not going to cheer up. I can't cheer you up and remain pained. No. Let us suffer the emotions together. Don't cheer anybody up. Not anymore. So please, I've told you, and in minutes, we should go. I'm going to be sitting with your coach. There are some things we are not going to accept anymore. When I saw your captain, I saw his mood. I knew, because there's one person that loves this country beyond comprehension. If everybody can demonstrate that, so please, won't take the blame. But the beauty about falling down is the resurgent enough is to bounce back. Bounce back in the grand style, because what you've done to them now is that you've given them confidence. Nigeria is beatable. Nigeria is this, Nigeria is that. They want to go there. I wish you go. he would have wished, oh, if only I could get into the field as a defender to defend this last game. The same thing to me, talking very, very seriously. We must re-engineer this team. We must go to Freetown. We must beat them in Freetown by those 4 goals. That we know truly that the Eagles landed. So please, please, please. Otherwise, like I can tell you, it's the truth. If all those players that let me know them playing national team, the highest player is Kai Kamara playing in FC Minnesota. That's it. Leicester, Everton, Rangers, the biggest clubs. But the important thing is that we're Nigerians. Even though we fought, but let's get up here. So please, double our effort, triple our effort, and go to Freetown and win that game. By 4-0, not 3. I know why. It is very symbolic for us to win by 4-0. So they will know that what happened in Nigeria was a fluke. Thank you very much. I think that is